Hi, it's Susanna B. Troy. I just wrote a long piece. If you got my link, I've added a lot more information. It's Bloomberg and SAIC singing Time is on Our Side, why they're celebrating the delays in the CityTime trial. You've got to read it. I added a lot more since I emailed it to you, if you got my email. And that ECTP is bigger than SAIC, CityTime, Technodyne, and there are subcontractors like Ariel. The rumor is that all the subcontractors pretty much, and actually Juan Gonzalez did talk about so many different contractors, but no one else is talking about it. And in my opinion, this goes way back to Giuliani time, that it was from the get-go completely corrupt, and Bloomberg, Rose Gilhern, Department of Investigation, Mark Page, top government officials, if we had a real U.S. attorney applying the law in a way that was equality, then you would have resignations and top people. But as it goes, even Christine Quinn, who went on New York One and she lied and said she was on top of CityTime, it was an infomercial. New York One will not ask tough questions, but they're not alone. Nobody in the media will. And anybody who was on top of CityTime was a crook stealing. Christine Quinn brushed aside two investigations into CityTime, and she discouraged a third. Let's get to Christine Quinn. I did a YouTube. I hope you'll watch it. It's short and quick. She doesn't take subways. She doesn't care about the people. She uses the gay card. Gay, 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 gay. Well, that's very nice. I'm pro-gay. But we need someone to run the city to represent the people, all the people of New York City. And when she talks about the living wage, she is Bloomberg Lite. She's full of crap. She's Marie Antoinette. She lives high off of taxpayer money with excessive legal bills. Quinn's legal bills are massive, including for her staff, and she approved Sullivan Cromwell for her staff, the same firm that Goldman Sachs uses for white-collar crime. So wake up, New Yorkers. Wake up, New Yorkers! We are being robbed. We have the largest white-collar crime, and as long as we delay CityTime and it's not front-page news, you don't know we have the largest white-collar crimes. We have all this theft and fraud and scams, the largest ever. It includes the tech sector in New York City governments, the massive, most white-collar crime, and no one seems to know. And if they did, Bloomberg would have to resign. Also, prediction that Rupert Murdoch will also be forced to resign. His tweeting is going to be his undoing, along with plenty of other things. Stay tuned for hacking. Stay tuned for hacking. And I want Bernie Kerik to sing. And if he sings, he gets to get out of jail early. Just my little thoughts.